Good afternoon. Welcome to St. Michael's Parish. We are so happy to be celebrating the sacrament of confirmation with our young people. As a quick reminder before Mass, we are taking precautions to protect each other, like wearing masks and social distancing, and at this time, refraining from singing. We ask that you sing in your heart or pray the words along with us. At the sign of the peace, please offer a bow or a hand wave to one another. At communion, we will bring communion to you in the pews. We ask that you receive in the hand for now. And now would you please stand and pray?
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
Truly an honor and a pleasure to be here to confer the sacrament of confirmation for our young men and women. And one promise that I make to those whom I confirm is every time I have confirmation, I pray for all those who have confirmed in the past, asking God to continue to strengthen the gifts of the Holy Spirit in you. So knowing that I have a number of confirmations this year, you'll be prayed for often. Let's join our prayers in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with all of you. As we gather in this sacred time of worship, let us first call to mind our sins and ask for the Lord's mercy.
Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who in the abundance of your kindness surpass the merits and desires of those who entreat you, pour out your mercy upon us to pardon what conscience dreads and to give what prayer does not dare to ask. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of prophet, a reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Let me now sing of my friend's song concerning his vineyard. My friend has a vineyard on a fertile hillside. He shaped it, cleared it of stones, and planted the choicest vines. Within it, he built a watchtower and hewed out a wine press. Then he looked for the crop of grapes, but what it yielded was wild grapes. Now, inhabitants of Jerusalem and the people of Judah, judge between me and my vineyard. What more was there to do for my vineyard that I had not done? Why, when I looked for the crops of grapes, did it bring forth wild grapes? Now I will let you know what I mean to do with my vineyard. Take away its hedge, give it to grazing, break through its wall, and let it be trampled. Yes, I will make it a ruin. It shall not be pruned or hoed, but overgrown with thorns and briars. I will command the clouds not to send rain upon it. The vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel, and the people of Judah are his cherished plant. He looked for judgment, but see bloodshed, for justice, but hark the outcry, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, have no anxiety at all, but in everything, by prayer and petition with thanksgiving, make your requests known to God. Then the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is gracious, if there is any excellence, and if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing what you have learned and received and heard and seen in me. Then the God of peace will be with you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Heart.
gospel worthily and well. Hallelujah. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the chief priests and the elders of the people, "Hear another parable. There was a landowner who planted a vineyard, put a hedge around it, dug a wine press in it, and built a tower. Then he leased it to tenants and went on a journey. When vintage time drew near, he sent his servants to the tenants to obtain his produce. But the tenants seized the servants, and one they beat, another they killed, and a third they stoned. Again, he sent other servants, more numerous than the first ones, but they treated them in the same way. Finally, he sent his son to them, thinking, 'They will respect my son.' But when the tenants saw the son, they said to one another, 'This is the heir. Come, let us kill him and acquire his inheritance.' They seized him, threw him out of the vineyard, and killed him. What will the owner of the vineyard do to those tenants when he comes?" They answered him, "He will put those wretched men to a wretched death and lease his vineyard to other tenants who will give him the produce at the proper times." Jesus said to them, "Did you never read in the scriptures, 'The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done, and it is wonderful in our eyes.' Therefore, I say to you, the kingdom of God will be taken away from you and given to a people that will produce its fruit." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Candidates for confirmation, please stand. Dear Monsignor Sefren, I present to you these young people of St. Michael the Archangel Parish who have completed a period of preparation for confirmation. They have deepened their knowledge of Jesus Christ by studying the truths of our faith. They have been strengthened by God's grace in the sacraments and have been supported by the prayers and the example of our parish community. I now ask you to celebrate the completion of their initiation into the life of Christ and to be sealed with the gifts of the Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Father Benson. I invite the congregation to join me in affirming our young men and women. Please be seated. Usually at this time of Mass, I ask the students to help me with my homily, but with social distancing, it's a little harder to do. But I want to remind everyone, who has already been confirmed? How many people do we have already confirmed? It's an important day for us, too, because we're reminded that the gifts of the Holy Spirit are permanent gifts, living gifts, that not only help us in our time on earth, but are part of the giftedness of God's grace for heaven, so that the gifts our young people will be receiving from the Holy Spirit are meant to help them for a lifetime to live their faith and to be prepared to give a powerful and joyful witness to Christ now and forever. Great gifts that can help immensely. That's why I remind all of us that have already received those gifts not to forget that we have them. The scriptures this Sunday continue an image that we've been hearing the last four Sundays, the vineyard. But it's a little bit different today. Up until today, the image of the vineyard has been an attempt to show us the working of the kingdom of heaven. But today, the image of the vineyard talks about the people of God. Notice in the first reading, Isaiah's friend is singing about his vineyard and all the hard work he's investing in it to plant the hedges, to plant the vines, to build the wine press and the tower. Hard work. It takes years for a vineyard to start producing fruit and the wine that comes from it. But the song turns to sorrow rather quickly, because after all that hard work, nothing but wild grapes grows. So in the sorrow of Isaiah's friend, Almighty God, he's ready to abandon the vineyard. And the vineyard is the house of Judah, the people of God. And he's concerned with them because they've been faithless, practicing idolatry, oppressing the poor, and being violent. So the people of God have wandered far from God and from a concern for each other. So when Jesus uses the image in the gospel, talking to the leaders of the people at that time, he uses the vineyard in a similar way that Isaiah does. All the hard work invested in the vineyard. And then he entrusts it to tenants that lease the vineyard. But notice, they don't produce any fruit for the owner. They keep it all for themselves. And the image of those servants that are sent are the prophets God sends to God's people that are rejected, ignored, and oftentimes threatened with death. So finally, God decides to send his son, and even he is killed and thrown out of the vineyard, Jerusalem. So it's a very unsettling image today in the scriptures that points out the failure of faith, the failure of righteousness, the violence and the evil that's being conducted. And obviously we live in a world that's oftentimes affected by the problems and difficulties of life also. So what might the image of the vineyard invite you and me to do, especially with the gifts of the Holy Spirit? How might those gifts make the vineyard a fruitful place? Well, one of the things that we're doing right now, which is a fruitful work of the vineyard, is being in praise of Almighty God. We're entering into the holy work of salvation whenever we praise God. It really is a holy work that changes our world, not only as we praise God for his goodness, but as we bring the prayers and petitions of the people we know, family or friends, prayers and petitions for people we don't know that well, but need our prayers and assistance. This holy work that we engage in is one of the fruits of faith that makes all the difference in the world in which we live. I can't imagine how much worse the world would be if we were not worshiping the Lord and petitioning him for the graces and gifts that we need to heal our country, our community, and our own hearts and homes. The gifts of the Holy Spirit can help us to discern how to use the blessings the Lord gives us Wisdom and understanding can help us to identify the challenges of our life. Courage can help us to make decisions that turn those problems into solutions. Truly, the gifts of the Spirit can help us not only in our relationship with Jesus and his church, but with each other. And that we can make a profound difference by taking the gifts the Lord gives us into the world in which we live. At the end of Mass, whenever the priest or the deacon dismisses us, he asks us to take the peace, the grace, the goodness that God has entrusted to us and take it into the world in which we live. Consider the things that we can do to make a difference in the world that we touch. Being loving and caring for your parents. Being attentive to your siblings or your classmates. Standing up to those that might be bullies that would harm the weakest among you. Recognizing the evils of racism and erasing it from your life. You become a blessing of peace and goodness whenever you strive to carry the goodness of the Lord into the world in which we live. And the gifts of the Holy Spirit are meant to help you as a young adult entering into the world that you can be a witness to the Lord by what you do, by what you say, by who you are. We really do work in the vineyard of the Lord, and when we use the gifts that he gives us, not only for ourselves but for others, we produce the good fruit of the gospel, and our world certainly needs it. Being a person of peace and mercy yourself, imagine how you'll be ready to forgive someone that hurts you or someone that you love. Bringing healing to those that have been hurt by others. Being a good listener to those that can be comforted simply because you're a friend. Being someone that searches for the truth and is willing to work for the truth, for justice, for our community, for our nation, for our world. It's not easy work in the vineyard. But when we engage in it with the help that God gives us, we can make all the difference. So my prayer for you today, and every time I celebrate confirmation, will be that the Lord will stir those gifts of the Spirit within you so that you can be the man or woman that the Lord wants you to be, and you can be the bearer of God's gifts to the world in which you live. It will guide you in your studies. It'll guide you in your choice of vocation. It'll guide you in your friendships and family. And truly, it builds up the body of Christ, the church, every time we gather in prayer, publicly or privately. So may the Lord bless you today with the gifts of the Spirit. May you always remember that you have them, and may you have the particular prayers of your sponsors and your parents so that you might live those gifts of the Spirit well as a good Catholic young man or woman. Working in the vineyard of the Lord is a privilege. It'll be filled with many blessings, and with the Lord's help, we'll be able to face the challenges of life knowing that he's always with us and his Spirit is at work among us. I invite our candidates to please stand. When you were baptized, your parents and sponsors made these promises for you. Today, as we renew our baptismal promises, we ask you to say them in your own name so that people can hear you give witness to the Lord. And since this replaces our creed today, I invite the rest of the congregation to say, "I do" also. So I ask you, do you renounce Satan and all his works and empty promises? Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who today, through the sacrament of confirmation, is given to you in a special way, just as he was given to the apostles on the day of Pentecost? Do you believe in the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? This is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord. For the prayer of the Holy Spirit, I'll invite the whole congregation to stand with me in prayer for our candidates. Dearly beloved, let us pray to God, the Almighty Father, for these, his adopted sons and daughters, already born again to eternal life in baptism, that he will graciously pour out the Holy Spirit upon them, to confirm them with his abundant gifts, and through his anointing, conform them more fully to Christ, the Son of God. I invite the sponsors to put your hand on the candidate's shoulder. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who brought these, your servants, to new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, freeing them from sin, send upon them, O Lord, the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and fortitude, the spirit of knowledge and piety. Fill them with the spirit of the fear of the Lord, through Christ our Lord. I invite the congregation to be seated. And our candidates and their sponsor to come forward for anointing.
Spiritus, benedicat spiritus.
Please stand for our petitions. My dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly pray to God, the Almighty Father, and be of one mind in our prayer, just as faith, hope, and charity, which proceed from the Spirit, are one.
For the gift of wisdom, to recognize and respond to God's presence in our lives and in the world, for our sponsors, for those in our families, in our church, and in our lives who have shared their wisdom with us, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the gift of understanding, to continue moving to a deeper experience of faith, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the gift of right judgment, to guide us in making decisions and choices that are true to our faith, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the gift of courage, to guide us in standing up for the values and beliefs of the gospel. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the gift of knowledge to enable us to deeply know God's love for us and to share that love with others, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the gift of reverence to lead us to honor God as the source of all life and to see all people as our brothers and sisters in Christ, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the gift of wonder and awe to lead us to respect, recognize, and trust God's divine role in the unfolding of human history and in creation, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the gift of gratitude, for our health, and the opportunity to live each day, may we use our gifts to help others, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are in most need of our prayers this day, for those whose lives have been ravaged by illness, oppression, war, homelessness, and disaster, especially those dealing with the ravages of the wildfire, and for President Trump and all those who are affected by the coronavirus, may they know peace, comfort, and healing, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those who have died, for the loved ones of those who are gathered here, for all who have gone before us, and for those who we are mourning the loss of someone dear to them, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. O God, who gave the Holy Spirit to your apostles and willed that through them and their successors the same Spirit be handed on to the rest of the faithful, listen favorably to our prayer and grant that your divine grace was at work when the gospel was first proclaimed, may now spread through the hearts of those who believe in you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the sacrifices instituted by your commands, and through these sacred mysteries which we celebrate with dutiful service, graciously complete the sanctifying work by which you are pleased to redeem us, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world and all its wonder, to rule in your name over all that you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, all the bishops and clergy. Remember also your sons and daughters whom you have been pleased to confirm today by bestowing the Holy Spirit, and keep them in your grace. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Please stand. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
As a reminder, the communion ministers will bring communion to you in the pew. If you are Catholic and prepared to receive communion, you may simply stand at that time. If you are not Catholic or do not wish to receive at this time, please cross your arms in front of your chest for a blessing. All others may remain seated. Would you please join with me in praying the prayer for spiritual communion, the Anima Christi, found in your worship aid?
Body of Christ.
Soul of Christ, sanctify me. Body of Christ, save me. Blood of Christ, inebriate me. Water from the side of Christ, wash me. Passion of Christ, strengthen me. O good Jesus, hear me.
Within thy wounds hide me. Separated from you, let me never be. From the evil one, defend me. At the hour of my death, call me, and close to thee bid me, that with thy saints I may be praising thee forever and ever. Amen.
Let us pray. Accompany with your blessing from this day forward, O Lord, those who have been anointed with the Holy Spirit and nourished by the sacrament of your Son, so that with all trials overcome,
they may gladden your church by their holiness, and through their works and their charity, foster her growth in the world through Christ our Lord.
Hello, folks. My name is Justin Hike, and I'm a pastoral associate here. And while I'm talking to you, I'm going to ask Rachel to come on up, too. So congratulations on your confirmation. You know, this began way back at baptism, right? And next weekend at Masses, our Knights of Columbus are going to be giving away little bottles of holy water after all our Masses to remind us of our baptism and that we're a baptismal community. So see the bulletin for more details about that. Now, for those godparents, sponsors who don't know, this is Rachel Schumar. She's our new fantastic youth minister. And what a year to have be your first year to prepare folks for confirmation. Can you give her a round of applause, please? She's also here to tell me if I forget anything. So she is currently taking registrations for youth ministry. So you can go right online and make sure you're connected and getting all the updates about youth ministry. And also, for those who have younger siblings in our Families Growing in Faith program, it's time to register for that, too. That's online. Of course, in confirmation, we learn how to serve and to give and to grow and to be people that pour ourselves out as Jesus did. And one way we do that is with our year-round food drive. So our special ask for our year-round food drive for next weekend is, and this goes to Catholic Charities, important agency in our church, shampoo, body wash, women's deodorant. So bring that next weekend. Thank you to everyone who's continuing this ministry. And of course, an important way that we continue to serve and to grow is to support agencies like Catholic Charities and also our parish. And so just as a reminder, we're not doing collections during Mass right now. So that collection area is in the back, and the basket's there. And that helps us to continue to live as a church and to support our ministries to help us live as people of mission. So those are the things, but I think I forgot something. Rachel, what did I forget?
After the final blessing, we ask if the confirmation candidates will come forward to take a group photo with Monsignor. Make sure to have your masks on, but we will be taking a group photo with the candidates.
You see what I have to deal with. Thank you, Justin. Thank you, Rachel. Monsignor, we want to thank you in a special way for being here. I think I have used a lot of your time these few days. For three consecutive weekends, you have been here, doing that long drive from Youngstown, just because of the love you have for us. Thank you for coming. So at this time, after the final blessing, please, we will respect this. We make sure we have our masks and then come up and take pictures with Monsignor.
Thank you, Father Benson, and thank everyone who had a part to play in preparing our young people to be newly confirmed. May the gifts of the Spirit give you strength and joy and wisdom in following Christ all the days of your life. Be assured of my frequent prayers for you, for your family and friends. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your head.
Bow down for the blessing.
May God the Father always bless you, whom he has made his adopted sons and daughters, reborn from water and the Holy Spirit, and may he keep you worthy of his fatherly love. Amen. Amen. May his only begotten Son, who promised that the Spirit of truth would abide in his church, bless you and confirm you by his power in the confession of the true faith. Amen. May the Holy Spirit, who kindles the fire of charity in the hearts of the disciples,
bless you and lead you blameless and gathered as one into the joy of the kingdom of God. Amen.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you now and always, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Out into the world, singing an hallelujah, dancing along the way. Let's get together and pray. Go now in peace, proclaim the good news with your life. Give thanks to our Lord on high. Give all the glory, give all the glory. Sing, sing hallelujah. Go out into the world, and everyone you meet, dancing along the way. Let's get together and pray. Sing hallelujah, hallelujah. Give glory to our King. Sing hallelujah. Heavenly hosts proclaim. Sing hallelujah. Sing hallelujah. Sing, sing hallelujah. Sing hallelujah. Sing, sing hallelujah.